Imagine stepping outside your house on a chilly winter day. You're bundled up in your warmest coat, thick gloves, and a wool hat. As you make your way towards your destination, you start to feel warm, and energy is released. Some of that energy is released into the atmosphere as heat. The principle of black body radiation is based on this concept. Now, let's break down the term black body radiation to understand the idea a bit better. A black body is a theoretical or imaginary object that perfectly absorbs all incoming electromagnetic radiation, and also emits radiation, like heat and visible light, based on its temperature. A black body is considered theoretical because no object can be a perfect absorber of electromagnetic radiation. Think of it this way. When you heat an iron rod, it becomes extremely hot, and its color changes to dull red, followed by bright red, orange, and then yellow. This is a good example of how black body radiation works. Imagine throwing a stone into a lake. It produces ripples that spread out in all directions. Electromagnetic radiation is somewhat similar, only instead of being made of water, these waves transport energy. These waves are of different sizes, or in more technical terms, you'd say that these waves have different wavelengths. Some wavelengths are short, while others are long, but each wavelength corresponds to a different form of energy. For example, the light we see around us is also a type of electromagnetic wave, with wavelengths in the range of 380 to 700 nanometers. The human eye is able to see electromagnetic radiation that falls within this range, and therefore it's called visible light. Similarly, there is also electromagnetic radiation that we cannot see, like radio waves with large wavelengths, which enable us to use smartphones and Wi-Fi. Another term you will often hear in correlation with blackbody radiation is the blackbody radiation curve. This is a simple graph that depicts the intensity of the emitted radiation from a blackbody on the vertical axis and the wavelengths of that radiation on the horizontal axis. Since the temperature of the blackbody is directly related to the intensity of its emitted radiation, you will notice that as the blackbody's temperature changes, the shape of the blackbody curve changes as well. At low temperatures, most of the emitted radiation is in the form of long wavelengths, for example, infrared, meaning that the radiation we cannot see with our naked eye. On the other hand, at high temperatures, the graph peaks at shorter wavelengths, which corresponds to colors that we are able to see. The process is comparable to how the color of an iron rod changes with the application of heat, as mentioned earlier, resulting in an increase in temperature. Now, what celestial body comes to mind when you think of very high temperatures and high amounts of radiation? The sun, of course. Although it's not a perfect black body, its surface is at a temperature of around 5,500 degrees Celsius, and a portion of the radiation it emits is in the range of visible light. Since blackbody radiation depends on temperature, this concept also helps us understand the temperature, size, and age of celestial objects, like stars and planets. By analyzing the radiation of a star, including its color and intensity, we can learn a lot about the physical properties of that star. The concept of a black body helps us understand how this emission happens, as well as the types of energy being emitted. This energy, the electromagnetic radiation, spans across multiple forms, including visible light, giving us the ability to observe and investigate the universe around us.